Okay, today we're going to look at note anytime. For this sample, I have a PDF open in front of me, and so if I click on that PDF, in the top right you see the save and send button. When you select that, then you should see open in note anytime as one of your options. This is how you always want to open a PDF in note anytime so that you can annotate on top of it. It'll take just a moment for it to convert the PDF file, and then you will have it open and able to do a myriad of things within the text. Okay, so while it's rendering, let me first point out the icon to the right. So it kind of looks like an eyelash, so like an eye that's closed. So I like to call this like the look, don't touch button. With that in mind, like you can zoom into the page, you can zoom out. At the bottom, if you notice, you have where you can scroll through the document. So this document has 18 pages, so I can just hit the arrows left and right to go through that. Or where it says 4 out of 18 pages, you can select that, and then it'll give you like a page jump. And so you could actually jump to whatever page you wanted. And once you did that, you would just select the same thing where it says 5 through 18 page, and that would get rid of the little page jump feature. All right, so say for instance we're on this page. So I would want to zoom in as if I'm going to answer these questions that I have over in the margin. All right, once I click on the eyelash, now it actually opens up my text for me. Okay, if you select the middle of that circle, like where the stylus is already selected on mine, you can then move that circle wherever you want. So maybe move it out of your way so you can read the text. Okay. What you see here are different functions, and so I'll walk you through the different functions. So let's start with the text tool. So it's the one with the uppercase T on it. If you select that, you'll see it'll place a text box at the top left for you. You can move that text box wherever you want it. You can make that text box as big as you need it. In this instance, you might want to move the text box like over to the right margin. And so you could add in your answer there. And then you can just type like normal and you'll see that text appear. If you were to get rid of your keyboard here, and then you could double click on the T, and then you're going to see where that is selected with some different options for you. Okay, so let's go back to our different tools. So within here, we have the text box, we have the stylus, we have the eraser. So let's go ahead and select our stylus. It would probably be the one that you use the most. Notice that your stylus is like a pen. It comes with 5 default kind of ink swiggle marks there. Each one of those can be changed however you want it to be. So for this, you'll notice that mine looks different than what yours will look like when you first open it. I've already selected to make myself a highlighter. So I would suggest that you choose one of the pens you don't like or don't think you'll need, and you just double click on that. And when you do that, then you're going to see where you have options. And so for a highlighter especially, you want to make that thick, like not crazy thick, but you know, somewhere like 50, between the 50 and the 20 mark. You can make it whatever color you want it to be, but the real key to that would then be the opacity. So you don't want it completely opaque, you want it to be where you can see through it. And so lowering that opacity to 50 or below will allow that to happen. And then you'll see the sample of it in the top left there. Once you're finished, you would just hit done, and now it will save that as your default within your stylus options. Notice at the top, you also could change this to a solid line, a dotted line, a calligraphy pen if you were interested in any of those features. Okay, and so now with my ink selected, so I just have it on a default black. Say I just want to write an answer here. So with my finger, I'm just going to then write on the page. Notice though, because I am already, this is where I'm zoomed in so that I can see how large it would make that. I mean, it would be really hard, or I'd have to zoom pretty far in to make that small. So I'm going to hit the undo button and show you a different way that you could do that. Also, if you'll notice, you can hit the undo button several times and just slowly do it, or If you select the eraser, so the big fat eraser within your toolbar here, and then just make it the thick one, now you can see me virtually erase and it goes away. So use that a lot more than the undo button. Okay, so I'm gonna select that pin again. And with that pin selected, I want you to notice your icons in the bottom right. And we'll talk about a few of these in just a minute, but the one I think you'll use the most will be the bottom right one. It looks like a magnifier glass with the plus sign. When you select that, you're going to notice that it gives you a box. And for this one, it like popped the box up like toward the top of the page there. And so I can move that box wherever I want it to be. And you see the zoomed in box at the bottom of my screen as well. And so maybe I want to answer here, like right below, indicate the satire. I can make that box smaller. And in doing so, give myself still the same amount of room to write my answer. Okay, and notice how it is there. Now my pin's probably a little too thick for that. And so it'd be a good idea to like make it a thinner pin, and you'll see with like a thinner pin the difference in me writing that. This is where definitely a stylus comes in handy, because then you're writing with what feels like a normal pen instead of your finger. And I think you would see your text just be even more legible in that instance. Okay, so that's the pen feature. And you can always collapse this at the bottom. I'm using that bottom right where it has like three lines and a little triangle. Something else that's interesting, especially for me, like I'm left-handed, I like the shield. And so when you're looking in the bottom right, those three icons, you have the look, don't touch. So you can always go back to that if you want it to stop marking on your page and you just want to scroll through or you wanted to zoom out. But the one in the middle, it has like the little hand. If you click on that, do you see how there's now like a screen, like a shield that popped up? You can kind of see through it. You can adjust that screen, place it wherever you want. And so for me, being left-handed, I could put it on the far left, rest my hand on that, and then nothing that my hand is touching would make a difference. So it allows for me to be able to write on my iPad a little bit easier. And just like anything else, you can use that little triangle to collapse it and make it go away. Let's see, if you are answering questions, so like this is an example from our textbook, and so you could go to like the last few pages in this document and see like normal questions from our textbook. And so I would just click that look, don't touch button again so that I can kind of zoom, I can look through my page. So say for instance, you were supposed to answer 1, 2, and 3. Well, maybe you feel like there's not enough space in order to answer that there. If you open up your features, and so anytime you want to see your features, you click on that little eyelash, and now you see all your features, the functions within the app show up again. You could click the plus sign at the top left, and you could add a page to this document. So instead of 18 pages, it would have 19 pages. You could add a page with paper, and that would give you just a blank piece of paper that you could then write your answers on and still have it all within this document. So that makes it nice as well. And then let me show you how to save, since that would be probably your last step here. So when you are looking at the top right, you see the undo button, you see the redo button, you see what looks like a picture, so you can actually access your camera roll if you were to select that. Import a picture, and then just like if you're familiar with Sketch, you could put a picture on the page and then annotate on top of that. You can do that here. But if you look at the, we call it the save and send icon, it looks like a piece of paper with an arrow pointing out. If you click on that, then you have quite a few options here. If your teacher asks you to send this to them by email, then you see where that's an option. You click on that, and now you have the current page. So if you only needed to send one page in the document, like maybe this was the only page you answered questions on, you could do that. You could send all of the pages as an image file, which if it's a textbook page like this, because of copyright, you'll need to do that. Or you could send it as a PDF. So a PDF would be a compressed file where it would have all 18 pages as one with your annotations. So that's through email. Probably what you'll use the most though would be submitting it as a schoolwork piece within MyBigCampus. So to do that, you can click send to application. And then again, you can click the current image or PDF. So for this, we're going to select PDF. And then notice how it says open in My Big Campus. Once you do that, what it will do is actually just save it to your stuff. So you have a folder in My Big Campus called Your Stuff. It doesn't submit it for you. You still have to go through the steps of submitting. But that way you have it in there and you could submit this document or whatever page you're working on to your teacher. Just a few other quick things in Note Anytime. So say you have this document open, but you just need a blank piece of paper, not part of this document, just a normal piece of paper that you want to take notes on. That plus sign, you could also just say create a note. And so when you do that, you then have options that it gives you for what kind of background page you want that note to be created on. So you could select through any of those. Also at the top left, you see where it has like a file folder. If you'll select that, say you're working on this document today and you don't finish, and tomorrow in class you're supposed to pick up where you left off, you do not have to save this. It automatically saves within Note Anytime. The only thing you have to do is if you were saving it as a PDF, you would have to go to the Save and Send button that I just showed you. But say you open up Note Anytime tomorrow and you want to find this document, well, you could always, if it doesn't open directly, you could always hit that file folder at the top. And that's going to take you to your virtual bookcase, so to speak. And so you have like sample documents of anything that you've already placed in there. And so make sure that it says in the top left all. Sometimes it will select one of those other things like the root file, and that might be why you don't see what you're looking for. But when you select all, you should see any document that you placed within Note Anytime. Okay? So that would be just your basic steps within here. I hope that helped. Thank you.